Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about performance modifications and upgrades for the 5.9 Cummins 24 valve. Of course, we have both the VP44 and the common rail CP3 5.9 24 valves. So we're gonna go ahead and cover performance modifications for both of those in this video. Despite them being very different platforms from a tuning, mechanical, and fueling standpoint, the basic list of performance modifications is relatively similar. And so I'll go ahead and do a video later on in the future about performance limits of each of the respective engines, as well as all of their systems, and talk about some of these more advanced modifications if you're looking to push a VP44 or a common rail into the higher horsepower limits. But both of these platforms get quite expensive to take to serious power levels. In this video, we're just gonna focus on some of the more basic bolt-on modifications to liven up your engine a bit, add a bit of power, and do it all without breaking the bank. So first off, let's go ahead and jump into the VP44. The VP44 isn't the strongest platform for modifications. The VP44 fuel pump itself is weak and does tend to fail frequently. And the transmissions in the VP44s can't hold a lot of power either. So you have two weak points with those things right off of the bat. But fortunately, with some transmission upgrades and a simple lift pump, we can actually make this relatively reliable and make it safe for adding some additional power. And the good news is these VP44 5.9s do make pretty good torque numbers. So while the horsepower figures aren't extremely impressive, you do get pretty strong torque levels out of these. And like I mentioned, it gets expensive to try to take this to some serious power levels. If you're looking to get into the mid to upper 500s level, you're gonna probably be looking at $12,000 to $15,000 in modifications. So we're gonna mostly focus on some basic bolt-on modifications that can get you to about the 375 to 400 wheel horsepower limit, which is a safe level without needing to get into a lot more expensive upgrades. First off, for the VP44, the thing you should do before you look at tuning or any additional modification is install an upgraded lift pump. The factory lift pump is problematic on these engines and is actually one of the common reasons that the VP44 injection pump itself fails. So to help support the VP44 and prevent it from failing, you're definitely going to want to add a lift pump. Once you've got the lift pump in place, then the best next option is tuning. Tuning is where all of your big power gains are gonna come from. Tuning is a little bit different on the VP44 because we have mechanical injectors on this engine instead of electronic fueling. So your typical EFI-based fueling is not available for the VP44, but fortunately there are a lot of other good options out there. My personal favorite or recommendation would be the Edge Comp Box, but Quadzilla is popular as well as the Smarty products too. Tuning is gonna be where all of your big power gains come from, but to maximize your benefits from tuning, you're going to need a boost elbow. A boost elbow is like 20 bucks, but the issues with the factory wastegate. Factory wastegate is limiting when it comes to boost, and so you can't run too much additional boost without upgrading the boost elbow. Upgrading a boost elbow for like 20 or 30 bucks will allow you to run closer to about 35 PSI of boost, which is gonna give you a lot bigger power gains from your tuning. After that, the next upgrades that I like to do would be a cold air intake and an exhaust system, just to help free up air flow within the engine. I think it's important to get more air into the engine to be able to support these higher boost levels, to be able to support the turbocharger, and then getting an exhaust system to be able to let the air flow more freely out of the engine. This is going to do a lot for freeing up the efficiency of the turbocharger, as well as reducing exhaust gas temperatures and adding a good touch of reliability to a tuned VP44. So those are the five modifications that should be able to get you to about 375 wheel horsepower, which is what I would say the safe limit is without starting to look at any additional modifications. The only things you really need to get there are tuning, a lift pump, your boost elbow, And then an intake and an exhaust are definitely beneficial. I would say they are a little bit more recommendations rather than must-haves. I would say an exhaust is probably a little bit more important just to help lower your EGTs and free up the exhaust flow. If you want to start pushing well beyond 400, that's when we're going to need to look at 100 horsepower over injectors, because the factory injectors are going to be tapped out at about that 375 wheel horsepower mark. Torque converter upgrade if you've got the 47RE, since that transmission is already pretty weak as it is. If you've got one of the manual NV transmissions, you'll want to look at clutch kit upgrades. And upgrading your transmission is good even if you plan it sitting around 375 wheel horsepower, because the factory transmissions will start to run into some issues once you add tuning, just because they can't hold a whole lot of additional power beyond stock levels. And then if you want to push things even further past that and start looking at going 500 plus, you're going to want 150 horsepower injectors, you'll need a larger turbo, you're going to have to upgrade the VP44, you'll have an exhaust manifold, springs, head studs, and eventually you're going to need a built transmission. That's why things start to get pretty expensive once we push those upper power limits. So that covers it for the VP44. Let's go ahead and jump into the CP3. The CP3 is a bit more favorable of a platform just because tuning is a bit easier on it, and the electronic fueling CP3 is a lot more capable than the VP44. But again, even the common rail CP3s are very expensive to take to serious power levels. If you want to look at the upper 500s to 600 plus, you're probably going to be looking at a $15,000 budget. In my opinion, the safest area to play with the CP3 common rails is the 400 to 500 wheel horsepower range. And that's what's going to get you good power gains, but be able to keep everything within a reasonable budget without having to dig into very expensive upgrades. So jumping in on the CP3 list, the first thing I have here is also a lift pump. The lift pumps were improved from 2005 onwards when they were moved to the frame rail, but the ones from 2003 and 2004 were problematic, and so I definitely recommend upgrading those, relocating them to the frame. And it's also still good to upgrade the ones from 2005 plus just to help support your CP3 and the fueling system, since the factory ones are nothing special. With the lift pump, your next best modification is going to be tuning. Tuning is different here because we have electronic fuel injection, so you can look at EFI tuning, which opens up options for things like EFI Live. If you are looking at keeping things at a relatively low power level, you can save some money and just get the Smarty. That's going to keep things within the safe limit of the transmission, and I believe it costs about $500 versus going for a more custom tuning solution like EFI Live, which will likely run you about $1,200, but it will give you more capabilities if you look at doing additional upgrades down the road, and it will allow you to fine tune and dial things in a little bit more than sticking with a standard plug and play programmer. After tuning, my next two recommendations here are also gonna be a 4-inch exhaust system as well as a cold air intake, just to help bring more air into the engine to support the turbocharger and to help lower your exhaust gas temperatures and keep your engine temps down for reliability purposes. Now, with proper tuning, if you're looking at something like EFI Live, you can easily push these common rail CP3s beyond 500 wheel horsepower, but the problem that you're going to run into is the transmission. The transmission, even at about 400 wheel horsepower, is a bit shaky, and so if you're looking at consistently running beyond 400, you'll want to look at transmission upgrades. If you've got the 48RE automatic, you'll want to upgrade the valve body as well as the torque converter. And if you've got the manual G series or NV series, you'll want to look at clutch upgrades if you're going to consistently run 400 plus. There are some transmission upgrade kits out there that can handle anywhere from 550 to 800 plus wheel horsepower. So with some transmission upgrades, you can take these things pretty close to about 600 wheel horsepower before you have to start looking at some more advanced modifications. To get there, you might need an upgraded turbocharger. Once you start looking at surpassing those levels, we're going to be looking at a built transmission. You're going to need dual CP3s. You're going to need larger injectors, larger turbo upgrades, head studs, and a number of other modifications that ultimately cost about $15,000 to do a serious build here. My recommendation is put a lift pump on it, get some tuning, do an exhaust and an intake, maybe get some transmission upgrades if you plan on running things at levels where you're going to put the transmission at risk, and be happy at those levels unless you have a really high budget and are looking to do a serious build. But fortunately, you can make pretty good power levels with just $2,000 of modifications on the common rail CP3s. Anyways, guys, that covers it for the performance modifications for both the VP44 and the common rail CP3 5.9 Cummins 24 valve. Like I mentioned, down the road, we'll do a little bit more advanced video on the VP44 and the common rail specifically so that we can dig into the power limits of the fueling systems, the transmissions, the turbochargers, and all of the other components. But I hope this video was helpful as you think about some of the basic bolt-on modifications and power levels that you could potentially hit with your 5.9 Cummins 24 valve. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for those future videos.